seconds remaining.
Ah.
Radiant team ban. Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Ah, come on.
Radiant team pick.
Keeper of the light.
Dire team pick.
All right. Hello, hello, ladies and gentlemen. Great. A little slow getting into this one here. Let's pop to my keybinds. Okay. All right, folks, welcome to Team Onyx versus Team IsGG. IsGG in a little bit of trouble here in this bracket. I think almost impossible for them to make it to the top. Big game for Team Onyx, though. They haven't played too many of their matches. And a win here definitely gives them a shot at the top four. So a big game. NA getting close to wrapping up. I think likely that there's tiebreakers. A lot of teams that are 1-3 right now. Thank you for joining us here in Client. Of course, I am Ziori, casting out of the Moonduck House. No stream for this one, just Dota TV action. I'll take a look at some of the bans and picks. We've got pretty meta bans here. The Earth Spirit and Juggernaut banned out by Onyx. And Lone Druid Meepo banned out by IsGG. First pick, Keeper of the Light, and it will be the classic Lifestealer Slardar. If you've been watching Dota in the past year, you've probably seen this combo a time or two. Blink Dagger Carrier, AoE Stun, amazing for Infest Bombs. Fairly safe opener. Though some would argue that it's been figured out at this point. The Meepo ban, in respect to Abed. One of few really confident Meepo players, I think, in the NA qualifier. And definitely something that they will pull out pretty regularly, honestly. He likes that Meepo. Baden now, second pick for Team Onyx. Another NA staple.
Radiant team back.
Probably their position 3 offlaner, but keeps things open-ended. Very nice to have against Slardar. You can use the Aphotic Shield, get off that Corrosive Haze. And a couple of hard carries banned out by IsGG. Weaver and the Terror Blade. And a couple of cores banned out by Onyx as well. OD. And the Ember Spirit. So sorry, I just want to tweet out real quick that we are officially going out, on in the client. I'm going to be following this thread for this game and the next one. I think it's Team Fire versus NP after this, so we'll be going back-to-back games here. Centaur War Runner, one of the other popular offlaners we've seen so far. Pretty much in every region. I've cast South America, North America, a little bit of EU, some CIS, and even a little China last night, and Centaur is just ubiquitous across the board. Hard to deal with. The Aghanim Scepter, a game changer.
Spirit Breaker.
Dire team pick.
Of course, this does confirm the position 4 Slardar, offlane Centaur and Lifestealer in the safe lane. Onyx strike back with a Spirit Breaker. An interesting choice. Good to have bashes against Lifestealer. They go through magic immunity, so that is a bit of lockdown, but RNG based.
5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Okay, I kind of like this draft from Onyx. A lot of mobility. We've got Coddle, who can do a lot of follow-up when Spirit Breaker gets on someone. You know, Mana League plus Spirit Breaker can be a pretty good combo. Even just a Abaddon Spirit Breaker can be quite good. Photic Shield, charge in. Spirit Breaker already very beefy, and just that little bit of extra damage and survivability can make all the difference in the world. It'll be interesting to see how Onyx decides to set up these lanes. It could be a Spirit Breaker, Abaddon off lane, Coddle safe lane, and just set up a 2-1-2, put some pressure on the Lifestealer. That's a really scary aggro dual lane, the off lane. Kind of reminds me a little bit of the Abaddon Weaver. Not exactly the same, but I think that was also a smart ban from IzGG. Photic Shield diving under towers. You have like a level 3 Weaver just destroying the safe lane. Very hard to deal with. And now Witch Doctor into a Medusa. Okay, very interesting pick here. So we have seen Witch Doctor making a resurgence, very popular in China, and a little bit in SEA right now. Glad to see NA giving the Witch Doctor some love. Sustainability and physical damage pairs very nicely with Slardar Lifestealer. You've got minus armor, Lifestealer probably going to pick up a Desolator, so that Death Ward's going to hurt. Medusa almost immediately, though. I guess pretty good against Witch Doctor. Once he drops his ult, he's looking in one direction. So in theory, Stone Gaze is pretty good there. You see this lineup, you know that they're looking for a mid last on the side of IzGG. Only so many heroes that you can grab and put in that role that counter Medusa, right? You know, you see a Medusa pick and you think Anti-Mage, you know, Beastmaster, Coddle in some cases, Nyx Assassin, anybody with a mana drain, anybody who can do well in terms of scaling int, that's where Nyx comes in, kind of twofold, just cripples Medusa. She's all about the mana, all about the mana shield when it comes to late game and having ways to cut through that. Oh man, it makes a big difference. So they're going to think about, I mean, they might be thinking about the Nyx ban here, but they ban out the Invoker, and that's probably the fifth one I should have rattled off. EMP Tornado, very strong against Medusa. Much more efficient than trying to lay physical damage into her. Minus armor, I think, not particularly great against Medusa. I mean, minus armor is always good. She takes more damage, but the nature of mana shield, mana drain, does significantly more. So I think it's a good pick in that regard, especially when you've got Abaddon who can cleanse off the Corrosive Haze, as we've already talked about. You've got Coddle with AoE Blinding Light. Spirit Breaker who can charge in, knock people out of the way, and oh god, even more. Now you've got a Vengeful Spirit with a stun swap. Extra damage for the Medusa, so she can feel a little more comfortable going for survivability-based items. We've seen Medusas have a really variable build. You know, you can go for stuff like Lincoln's first. We've seen like Phase Boot, Siasha into Maelstrom and just play her like a right-clicking carry. A lot of different ways to do it, but when you have extra damage from a hero like Venge and all this survivability, gives you even more flexibility. I think Medusa will probably just look for some stats early on. I mean, Lincoln's pretty goddamn good here. Open Wounds, Corrosive Haze, Coconut. It's one of these games where it doesn't absorb a lot, but the few things that it does absorb are really, really good. And Alchemist, final pick for IzGG. Okay. Well, a fair choice. You see a Medusa, a Coddle, you think, okay, they will be able to defend high ground. This is probably going late, more likely than not. And what hero better than to move into the late game than the Alchemist? A lot of good Aghanim's upgrades here. Well, okay, I said a lot. Two really good ones, Witch Doctor and Centaur. Of course, Slardar doesn't have one. Lifestealers, it's cute. I wouldn't say it's amazing, but hey, you know, it's more late game. Give him some stats. Certainly, Lifestealer won't be upset to have an Aghanim's pulled his way if this goes ultra late game. Diffusal Carriers can also be pretty okay against Medusa, as we talked about Mana Drain. Alchemist, not really the hero for that. Kind of curious what build the Alk is going to go for. It's usually safe to assume it'll just be the classic Radiance, Manta, you know, all that kind of stuff. Move into a pause straight away. Very interesting drafts, though. I think I like the Team Onyx draft just a little bit better, because the Medusa can be deceptive in that she doesn't necessarily have to be that ultra late gamer before she does anything. It's one of those heroes that has a rap for being, oh, she's a raid boss at 50 minutes. But if you go for that Phase Boots, Yasha, Aquila kind of style, maybe mix a magic wand in there, she does a lot of damage in that 10 to 15 minute mark. And Stone Gaze can be an amazing team fighting tool. You have to be careful how you use it. Once it's down, it's kind of a green light for the enemy to jump on you. Lifestealer can close the gap. Could be all over. Demon down bottom on the Coddle. Might actually get surrounded. This could be a good opportunity for IzGG. Slardar. Blocking the retreat. He does have a couple of tangos, so he could shoot through a path in the trees. Stan King on the other side drops the stun. Here's the Alchemist on his way in. And Demon will just head for the hills. He's going to try to suicide into the tower, it looks like. And he will be successful. All right, well, split across the team instead of going to one hero, so it's a minor victory there for Demon. Obviously not ideal, not really what he was hoping for. Dubu finding some bashes here. Seems like the Centaur is not so happy about it.
The battle begins.
Alk, I'll pick up a bounty rune. And we will move to lanes. So it's a safe lane Centaur coming out of IzGG. Alk mid. And they will do an aggro try off lane. This is a pretty nasty aggro try, to be honest. Lifestealer, Witch Doctor, and Slardar. You've got two stuns. Just a lot of right click. They will give up on the aggro try. They see that there's aggro try coming out of Onyx as well. Another quick pause. Abed probably knows all too well. So yeah, up top the aggro try coming out of Onyx, Vengeful Spirit, Spirit Breaker, and Keeper of the Light with a position 1 Venge soaking up the farm. Not something we mentioned in the draft, but play a sign that Onyx will want to be aggressive in this mid game. Mason racking up the farm. We'll rotate these supports to try to match him head on. One TP and Slardar slowly walking his way to the top. Alchemist versus Medusa mid. I think that matchup is kind of a wash. Neither should be able to easily find a kill. Without a rotation from a support, of course. It will be Lifestealer versus Abaddon in this bottom lane. I think that's pretty good for the Lifestealer. Though at the same time, Abaddon will get a lot of experience, and so far he's getting decent farm of the lane that's kind of a wash. So it should come down mostly to this top lane. Satyr Tormentor tosses a Hadouken the way of the Slardar. Softens him up a little bit as they pull into this hard camp. Kind of an odd top lane, though. Vengeful Spirit, 5-2, compared to the farming Centaur, 4-0. Winner of this lane will have such a big advantage. Double AoE stuns on the side of IzGG, paired with a Witch Doctor. That's a lot of control. Your Baden's not there, he's like the one hero that can deal with it. Charge mid lane onto the Alchemist. Dubu just harasses him back, says this rune is mine, denies it, and picks it up himself. Beautiful play there. Makes the Alchemist have to be a little more cautious for this next wave or two before he can ferry out his items. Up top, Stan King barely survives, and now Vengeful Spirit might get turned on. It's a 3-on-1. Mason can't quite find the Doctor in the trees, and he will get caught by the stun. This should be a kill onto Mason. This Venge pretty tanky. The right clicks, not doing enough. Stun, but double edges there, and Mason will fall. While that was going on, bottom lane, Harry Potter. On the Abaddon, gets the kill on Jao. The help of a rotation from Dubu's Spirit Breaker. So now the rotations continue. Centaur heads to the bottom lane, and up top, Jayo will file in on the Lifestealer. Turning back into a slightly more standard laning stage, perhaps. Harry Potter takes the double edge as Dubu charges across. X onto the Centaur. Ooh, gets the bash. Mason, not expecting that. Did have a stun ready, but instead focuses on farming. Fairly unlikely bash there. But works out okay in the end for the Centaur. Good old Alki. So, more rotations. Abad now headed up top. They're trying to match him up with the Lifestealer as best they can. He's found a fair bit of farm, but Lifestealer's still doing okay himself. Coddle dropping some blasts. They really want to pressure this Lifestealer. Slardar struggling to have a strong impact. These huge rotations have actually been hard on him. He's found level 3, but it feels like he's spent a lot of time just running around, moving from lane to lane. Onyx pretty successfully dodging him. Mid starting to move in favor of Medusa. Phase boots picked up first. Centaur denies himself to some neutrals. We see some pings up top. Illuminate connects onto Jayo. Open wounds the other way. The Abaddon's only level 5, no borrowed time. Right click after right click, they should be able to find a kill here. Mason, meanwhile, sets up a kill down bottom onto Stan King. They do finally bring down the Abaddon, but actually it could be a turn onto Slardar. Demon, he has the right clicks for it. Onyx gets the better of this trade. Jayo will try to chase him down, but creep's starting to add up. The TP home from Demon. Quick fingers there. He will live. Meanwhile, mid. Now Alchemist dies. Huge rotations across the map for Team Onyx. Ubu getting very active with the Spirit Breaker. Radiant pulling a nice lead for themselves now to almost 1k. Experience to boot. You can see the difference on the level chart. Three in the top three. Now a charge down bottom. Mason does not have mana for a stun. He's got a clarity, but not going to use it. As I say that, he pops the clarity. They might have a go. There's the magic missile. Dubu does have a charge. This should be another kill on the Centaur. And it absolutely is. Mason on the Vengeful Spirit starting to pull ahead. Has not surpassed the Alchemist yet, but this is exactly the kind of start you want within a bad and Vengeful Spirit type lineup. Baden still keeping up with this Lifestealer, but only level 5. Jayo trading blows, Illuminate comes in, and that kind of changes the dynamic. Now back down bottom, Vengeful Spirit hit by the Maledict and the stun from the Slardar. He's on the run, and I think Mason can still survive here. He's got a little bit of regen from that ring, and he will be good. Very nice. Alk now moving into the jungle. He's got the Iron Talon, just moving into Armlet. Fairly standard stuff on him. Still hard to say if he's going to go into the Radiance. I always like to bring up that Fighting Alchemist build. It's rare, but it does happen occasionally. It can catch people off guard. Fighting Alk is, you know, like SNY, Armlet, Solar Crest, Blink, BKB. A lot of small ticket items, and if you go for that build, you can get maxed out before 30 minutes. And if you're six slotted with all value items like that, they give you a huge boost. It just feels unkillable. And you can man fight, charge the base, just BKB, run up to the high ground with all the regen. It's scary. You think about an anti-mage at 30 minutes, if he's got three items, it's not too bad, including the Battle Fury. But pretty rare. And I think generally speaking, the Radiance Octarine style is very safe. Allows you to just soak up all the farm around the map, constantly push out lanes, clear out enemy jungle. It's the more tried and true, for sure. Up top is GG, perhaps looking to have a go. Just a 3-on-3 for now, but Zyra could TP in some reinforcements. Witch Doctor level 4, Slardar level 4 also. So Onyx put pressure onto this tower. Mason turns the ring back on. That extra armor for the team. Is GG doing the math? And here comes Slardar. He cuts through the tree line. Instant stun from Mason. The cast will not find any bounces, but Jayo focused right on the Vengeful Spirit. They get the kill onto the Slardar right away. Now Mason on the run. He'll be able to survive. Infest inside of a creep. It's another good fight for Onyx. Abaddon, this time he's level 7. He's got the borrowed time. It gives him the reset he needs. This should be a free tier 1 after that fight. It certainly is. TP in from the Slardar. Actually, another TP on the way. It's the Centaur as they rendezvous with the Witch Doctor. That shield returns a huge amount of damage. Stampede from the Centaur. Connects on Keeper of the Light on the backside. But Demon, he's still pretty healthy. He'll just run for it. He leaves the Abaddon high and dry. A big rotation from IzGG, and they only find the Abaddon kill. Meanwhile, in the mid lane, charge from the Spirit Breaker. On to Alchemist. Might not be enough for the kill, though. Snake comes through. He even gets another bash. And SK with the armlet, able to survive through it. And just goes back to regenning up. This is still great for Onyx, though. It's a sign of life out of IzGG, but 2k net worth lead for the Radiant. Never good when you're the team with an Alchemist and you're behind at this stage of the game. Medusa keeping up with him pretty much blow for blow. If we check in on CS, Medusa actually out CSing him right now. Abed playing like an absolute madman with this mid Medusa. Snake very hard to lane against. Bottom tier 1 goes the way of Onyx. Another easy tower kill, and they might just keep this 5-man roll, and they have an amazing early 5-man squad, and this is exactly what I was talking about with the Medusa. Phase Boots, Dragon Lance, just early combative survivability items. Abed moving around, putting pressure on the Alchemist. He took down the tier 1 tower in his own lane, and now they're pressuring a tier 2 at the 10-minute mark. Just look how fast the Alchemist dies. Medusa just brings him down with a snake after Magic Missile. Slardar goes in, but he ends up suiciding for the most part. Stone Gaze to try to slow down this Centaur. They can't find any of the kills that they're looking. And instead, they look towards the tower. Stan King caught by the Nether Strike. They get a bash, and that will be the end of the Witch Doctor. Oh my, things rapidly falling apart for IzGG. Almost a 4,000 net worth lead. Position 1, Vengeful Spirit. A strategy that's often criticized for being very all-in. When it works well, and when it fails, it fails. In the games, when it looks good, it has to have that perfect, crisp execution. And so far, so good for Onyx. We'll see another charge mid onto the Slardar coming out of Spirit Breaker. He connects. Mason does not have enough mana for the Magic Missile. But Abed's here. He's got the Schneck. And that will be yet another kill for the Radiant. 10-4 as we roll past the 10-minute mark. Dragonlance up on Medusa, and Onyx continue their reign of dominance. Now the non-stop charging begins. A field day for the Spirit Breaker in a game like this. JL gets caught by the charge. No Nether Strike for 25, but there's also no Infest. Dubu knows he can't win this battle. He will TP home. Makes the smart call. Now some reinforcements come for his GG. Mason could be in a bit of a sticky wicket here. Kask comes about. Stun onto Slardar. He might still be able to get the crush, and he will. Curse from Witch Doctor connects, and now the Lifestealer joins the fray. Dubu, he's back. Blinding Lights already come out from Demon. Demon's actually on the hunt here. They've got a Mud Golem. Stun's on cooldown. Onyx with a lot of control right now. Playing aggressively, but not too much. Really heads up play from Dubu to just TP out and then immediately hit the shrine and come back. Very smart play. So now the tier 2 under siege. Glance at the graph, and with Alchemist farming in the jungle, he is making a dent. The 5-man from Onyx does cost them in terms of farming. He's working on the Radiance. This is really scary. Onyx have so much momentum right now. There's only one outer tower remaining for the Dire at the 12-minute mark. But one failed fight. If Onyx gets wiped one time without killing this Alchemist, this game gets so much harder. Alk hasn't broken away from the pack yet, but he still can. Taking outer towers is a completely different story from breaking high ground. Take a look at overall inventories. And pretty poor, for the most part, on the Dire side. Centaur gave up hope for the Blink Dagger, and now it looks like he may be pooling for it. Gonna hold off on the HOD. I think it's a smart choice. Slardar, he wants the Blink, but just now got his Tranquil, so that's not coming for quite some while. As we see the Medusa working on Scotty, not even feeling like he needs the Lincolns. See Onyx just take out a nice early Roche, another benefit of the Vengeful Spirit. And the sieging continues. Onyx just head right back towards the mid lane. Deuce are very beefy right now. But the Roche still nipping at the heels of the Alchemist. You know, and as I say, the Alchemist could still bring this game back. Not all hope is lost. It goes the other way. One more lost fight, and Onyx are going high ground, I think. So this could end very quickly either way. On a bit of a hairpin trigger, and similarly enough, this... Oh, nice deny from Slardar. But similarly enough, this game could extend to be a 30, 40, 50 minute game. You know, Medusa Cottle on one side. Centaur, Slardar, Alchemist on the other. A lot of good high ground defense. A lot of good late game. Tier 3 tower down bottom, now under siege. Onyx just head right up to the high ground. Up top, they leave Demon to split push. Him and Stan King are going to duke it out. Demon will survive through this, I think. Meanwhile, down bottom, tier 3 tower dies. Just look at this, the Dire can't do anything. Stun onto Centaur. Now the Stone Gaze from Abed. It's just too much. Is GG are about to have to GG here as they lose two immediately, soon to lose their Lifestealer. And the Alchemist just trying to head back to the well. Mason says, not so fast there, Stan King. Swaps him back in. It's a 4-0. Bottom lane of Barracks down. And that fight was honestly a 4v5. Demon wasn't even there. He just shoves the creep into the top lane. And now the rest of his squad rotates mid. This is going to be a quick one here, gang. Team Onyx with a very convincing Vengeful Spirit strat. Just rolling over is GG. This gold graph out of control for 14 minutes. That's a tier 3 tower down. Maybe still a chance at a hold. Medusa does not have Stone Gaze. But Alchemist just doesn't have anything. I mean, Radiant's still 600 gold away. They pop the Shrine, stampede in, some decent damage coming onto the Radiant, but it's only the Abaddon. He's got the ultimate still. Alk trying to channel out the stun, but he can't get it off. Swap from Mason will keep him alive. He goes back in for more. Remember, he does have the Aegis. It's utilized now. He'll come back with full health as Slardar charges in, sets up the Illuminate. Blink stun from Centaur, does find a counter kill. Maybe Onyx going a little bit too deep here. They haven't finished off the barracks yet. Abed in too far as well. Minus armor, Death Ward bouncing around, but Jao overcommits out of the base. Buyback now from Jao. Barracks do stay standing. Onyx cut their losses and get out. Take a look at that team fight recap. And it's a very minor net worth gain for IsGG, but they have to use a buyback on one of their precious cores. And this will really stymie the Lifestealer's item progression. Very nice. And Medusa celebrating victorious. I say, good sir. Hurricane Pike completed for the Deucer. God, Onyx is just unrelenting. They're going to smoke up and go right for it. Is GG with the same idea. It's a smoke on smoke action. Who's going to find it? They pop the Shrine maybe a little bit early. Abed with a big ultimate. The Stone Gaze is going to petrify a few. Centaur will fall. Lifestealer gets petrified. Nether struck. The Snake will chase him down and he will die. Effectively a dieback for the Lifestealer now and a charge onto the slithering, sprinting Slardar. Swap from Mason. He jukes out the stun. A clutch play. Drops the magic missile and Slardar will not be able to live. Mason, God. The Centaur realizes it as he jukes the hoof stomp. Beautiful execution. XD, XD. Nice to see some good sportsmanship across these teams as the GG is called, a 17-minute decisive victory for Team Onyx. Hot diggity dog. What a match, what a game. Thank you for joining us here, folks. I am Ziori. You can find me on Twitter at ZioriTV. I'll have one more game coming up here in client on...